I'm looking at a baseline that is taken in simplified form from an adagio in a sonata by Giovambattista Pescetti, an Italian 18th century composer. So for the very first two measures I see. So in the scale of E major I see 1-5-5-1. I could also put the model outlined by Robert Yering in the Meyer. Next, I see a descending scale. Very much like the rule of the octave, I can do. A very elegant way to smoothly take me from the tonic E major to the dominant key of B major. This looks like. And so on, a moto del basso, falling by third, rising by step. So again. The rest seems to be just a very nice cadential pattern with the deceptive cadence included. So much for the first part. The second part opens, apparently as the first part, just in the dominant key. I see and if I look further I will see that eventually the bass will do a cadence into C sharp minor, so here in measure 9 and 10 the E, D sharp, C sharp could mean I should head towards C sharp minor. In that case I will choose to do, thinking already in C sharp minor, scale degree 3, with a 6th chord, with a 6th chord leading to C sharp minor. What follows is similar to the first part. And also, pattern that confirms C sharp minor. Next, I see leading note to B, leading note to E. This could be just a simple way to get back into E major. So measure 14 is kind of recapitulation. Again, the descending scale. I could do also, to stay more in E major, it's a little difference. So note that here, what follows same as in the first line, but just staying in E major. And confirming. Enjoy listening to this Adagio in E major, taken from a set of sonatas, the title page of which reads Sonate per clavicembalo, nuovamente composte e in segno d'ossequiosa gratitudine dedicate all'illustrissima signora Grazia Boyn, degnissima ed unica figlia dell'eccellentissimo Lord Viceconte Chanon, dal suo umilissimo ed obbligatissimo servo Giovambattista Pescetti, Londra nel 1739.